Hey folks, welcome to another Triple T Thursday. For those of you just joining us, that's tools, tips, and talk, centered more for the maker, where the build videos on Sunday are focused more on entertainment and folks watching knife making. So in today's episode, I want to talk about the new forge, which I've completed. I'll take you through that. Really excited about that. I've had a chance to use it once already. Works really well. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. So I'll show you that. But before we get into that, I wanted to talk about a couple of new projects. And I'm kind of in the new project phase right now. I've got three projects that I'm just starting. So there probably won't be a build video this Sunday just because I'm in the startup phase and nothing ready to show you guys yet. The first one is going to be one of these guys. So my friend Brandon is doing a big banner for me, and in exchange, I'm going to do a cleaver. And this one is going to be using raindrop Damascus, which I don't think I've ever shown before. So I'm going to do a raindrop Damascus pattern on that guy. The next big project, which is really going to be a much longer one, and you're probably going to see some videos, some other projects kind of interspersed, because I think it's going to be a really long one. And that one, that series is going to be building a wakizashi. And for those of you that are not familiar, that's the kind of a shorter katana. So a Japanese sword. The most daunting thing about the Japanese weapons is actually the terminology and getting all the terminology right. What is a manuki? What is an Edo wrap? And learning all these terminologies is taking me a while. So part of it is the research and actually doing it. So I'm excited to get some of that build started, and I'll take you along. That one could be a 5-6 parter, we'll see. But this one I'm gonna get started, and then there's a third project that I'm also starting, not gonna let the cat out of the bag on that one, but that one should be a pretty cool build too. So lots of new stuff coming up in the new year, new projects. But first, let's take you through the forge and show you the final results of the forge build. Let's take a walk around the new forge. So first off, the really cool doors that I'm really excited about. They just run on this track. It doesn't actually touch the bottom, so that's really cool. I'll light it up for you in a minute. It's all soft fire brick. There's one layer of soft fire brick, and then on the bottom and sides there's hard fire brick, and then there's mizu on the bottom, about a quarter inch of mizu on the bottom, just so that there's no flux that goes between the cracks. It's got 14 gauge casing. I've welded a piece of 4-inch by 6-inch angle on here, so there's a nice sturdy shelf. I just made a whole big box enclosure, and the top of the box, it's got both of the sides welded on it and all around. It's actually just sitting there, so the whole box comes off of this. The top brick, the whole top of it inside with the fire brick, actually comes off because I want that to be replaceable so I can change the lining on the inners, on the hard fire brick. On the back, I have this door that I was going to put on here and then realized that it would just be easier. So what I did was take a soft fire brick and I kind of tapered it. So it's kind of like a plug, and it just kind of plugs this whole thing, which is makes it really convenient. I had some 2-inch angle here, so I just did that, so I had a bit of a shelf. I don't need a big shelf on the back. Ribbon burner, we're gonna see that lit up. 1 1/4 inch pipe feeding to the ribbon burner, which goes down. This is coming in here. This is just, I just welded this on here with a set screw. So there's a gauge, obviously it's on the inside, and a needle valve here. There's a gate valve here for the air, and then the blower, and this is just a Dayton blower. And remember, look in the description, you'll see the parts list for this whole thing. And then obviously, it's just got a switch here. If I can flip it around just to turn the blower on. Because I don't have a guard on the blower, it's a bit louder, but it's no big deal. Okay, let's fire it up. Okay, here we go. I'm just gonna flip the valve. That's a pretty good flame if I turn up the gas. So I've got the tank at about 4 or 5 PSI and the needle valve is wide open. So that's running about 4 PSI. If I crank open the air, and as it gets hotter, it'll run even better. So let's see how long it takes to heat up. So it's been heating for about 10 minutes. It's almost up to temp now. One really interesting thing about the forge is you don't see a lot of flames coming out of it because of the way you can dial it in. If I open up or I close the, let's see, what I'm doing is closing off the blower so there's less air getting to it and more fuel, you can see the flames coming out of the front. But it's much more efficient because it mixes all of the fuel in the pipes instead of the fuel actually burning once it comes outside and hits more air, which is what you get at a Venturi forge. So very, very efficient. Right now it's running at about 2 PSI. And the interesting thing is if I, I'm gonna open it up to about 5 PSI, and you really won't notice that much of a difference. Okay, so that's a lot more gas. Okay, so I don't have enough blower. So I don't have enough blower to bring that flame down. So I think it's running at about 4 PSI now. I'm gonna drop it to about a 0.5 PSI. Okay, so it's running about 0.5 PSI now. I've got the needle valve all the way open. And now the air is all the way on. That's 0.5 PSI. So that's probably enough to get this forge going. And if I turn the gas down a little bit, it'll take these flames out. And you really don't notice much of a difference. I can run this forge at between 0.5 and 1 PSI, probably 1 PSI for forge welding. I'd say it's working pretty good. Thanks for joining me on this Triple T Thursday. I'm really excited about all the new projects coming up, excited about using the new forge, doing some forge welding in that baby, and getting things going. So. If you like these builds, please stay tuned. Remember to like and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.